I want you all to put your hands together, stand to your feet, get ready to receive our special guest, pastor of Second Baptist Church, Pastor Soraya.
Say amen.
Amen. Come on, give God praise up in here. Come on, give him praise. Because if it had not been for the Lord on my side, where would I be? I thank God for Jesus. I thank God for saving me. This is the day that the Lord has made. We ought to rejoice and be glad in it. Amen. I give honor to God, to the angel of this house, Pastor Johnson, to Sister Johnson in her absence. Pastor Johnson, a great man. You know, I carry this everywhere I go. This the book he wrote. So everywhere I go, I carry this up and down the highway. It blessed my heart. I want to say to him that keep doing that, man. It's a great literature in here. Amen. I also give honor to all the respected individuals, the preachers in the house, the deacons. I give honor to my own deacon, Deacon Randy Edwards, and to the best woman on this side of heaven, my boo. I can stick my chest out. She's been running with me for the last 35 years. Listen, y'all have already blessed my heart. What that young lady was teaching Sunday school? Oh man, she set the house in order. Amen. And now, this is a preaching atmosphere. And if y'all get along with me, give me about 20, let me holler for about 5. I think we can do something up in here. Amen. We just love God. Those of you who don't know what Dixon, Illinois is, it's a suburb of Rockford, Illinois. It's about 45 minutes south of Rockford. If you know anything about Rockford, Rockford sits on the other west of Chicago. So if you've never been to Rockford, you probably won't know where is Rockford. Amen. So I greet you. I'm an Arkansas boy. I'm a country boy. Is in Arkansas in the house? Amen. Amen. Hey, certainly, we want you to turn with me. We won't be before you long. I'm not one of the preachers that preach an hour. Because what I can do in an hour, I can say in 25. The book of Acts. First chapter. Book of Acts. Verse 21 through 26. Book of Acts. Chapter 1. Verse 21 through 26. Everybody have that? It says, wherefore of these men which were accompanied with all the time that the Lord Jesus went in and among us, out and among us, beginning from the baptism of John until that same day that was taken up from us. Must one be ordained to be a witness with us of his resurrection? And they appointed two, Joseph called Barnabas, who was surnamed Justus, and Matthias. And they prayed and said, Thou Lord, which thou knowest the heart of all men. Show what of these two thou hast chosen, that he may take part of this ministry and apostleship, for which Judas by transgression failed, that his might go to his own place. And they gave forth their lots, and the lot fell upon Matthias. And he was numbered with the 11 apostles. Thus in the reading of his word. Look at your neighbor. Say, neighbor. Pastor's going to preach about. Why not me?
Why not me?
You know, we are living in warfare. When you are in warfare, the decisions you make will cause you to win or lose the war. I'm concerned this morning because the people of God seem to have lost their way when it comes to the things of God. Because we as people of God seem to possess a worldly attitude when it comes to the way of God. I'm concerned this morning when we seem to have a good time on the stuff that God blessed us with, that we forget about who blessed us with the stuff. I'm concerned this morning because it seems that we have the right shout, but don't have the right heart. Christians seem to do anything, say anything, go anywhere, smoke anything, drink anything, listen to anything, lay anywhere and with anybody. The same people that say, God, I love you, live in any kind of way. Don't have enough time to put God on their schedule. Some of us come this morning busted and disgusted. Some of us come this morning not knowing how we're going to make it. Now God has lifted you up, and you got the nerve to come to church when you want to come, do what you want to do, wear what you want to wear, and say what you want to say. God is getting upset with us. My brothers and my sisters, God wants to move up in here. But he can't move up in here when everybody's sleeping with everybody. How can we get out of a service with all that anointing going on? Get right outside the exit door and light up a cigarette. How can you pass your phone number with all that shouting going on in service? Honey, if that's the man that God bless you with, he'll come up to you like a man, and give you his phone number. It's good that we can live, that God can brag on us. I didn't say you to brag on, God to brag on. We as children of God, we always trying to look for a pat on the back. I'd rather get a pat on the back from God than a pat on the back from folks. You ought not be doing what you're doing to get a pat on the back. Because some people got the wrong idea. You can leave your hood go get with somebody else. Marry them. People will pat you on the back. Girl, you got it going on. You can get high. Y'all know about that, don't you? People pat you on the back. Brother, you cool. You can be living with a man. Unmarried. He ain't working. He ain't trying to work. He ain't got no money. He certainly ain't trying to find a job. But as long as he finds, some of your friends will tell you, girl, you got a bad man. But I stopped by to drop a bomb on them. They ain't telling you right. They ought to be telling you. Send his in to McDonald's. Give him $5. Let him buy him a Happy Meal. Change the locks while he's gone. That's what he ought to be telling you. Let me get in my text here. Let me get here. After the ascension of Jesus, the disciples overcame the temptation to live stuck, gazing at glory that transported the Savior from time to eternity. Those that witnessed the resurrected Lord decided that it was time to get back to everyday life and get busy working for the kingdom. First on their agenda was filling the void left when Judas hung himself for betraying the Lord to his enemies. Now Judas there created an opening, and God's desire was the group would be number 12. The number 12 symbolized Old Testament tribe of Israel. So there, the work had to be done before the coming of the Holy Spirit. The infant gathering, this small band of believers that was the church, had positioned themselves in order for God to prepare for what God was going to bring next. So, to begin the process, Peter stood and took principal leadership and authority. Peter suggested they ought to fill the void immediately. So Peter laid down the criteria. Peter said that person had to be somebody who has been with us from the beginning until Jesus was taken up from us. Because our witness most include the resurrection. He needed folk who could tell us more than Jesus lived and died. So my brothers and my sisters, God is a good God. That was to give hope to the people. What would give hope to people is an eyewitness account to the fact that he lived, he died, and he was resurrected from the grave. So Paul claims apostleship because he was far removed from being an actual witness of the resurrection. Paul lays claim to apostleship because what the disciples saw in the physical, he has seen in the spiritual while he was on Damascus Road. Paul used his theological understanding to demand that they give him the right hand fellowship as an apostle of the Gentiles. When Peter had finished speaking to the fellow believers, the Bible revealed that two men fit that bill. They were identified as Joseph and Matthias. The people went through the process, and they went and they finished. Matthias was chosen to become part of the 12. When Matthias was chosen, you could see with your spiritual eye, everybody was celebrating. Now they can get on with the work of the ministry. But Paul said, my spirit wouldn't let me rest there. Paul said, I kept on thinking about the one chosen, but the one not chosen. What about Joseph? The man of God did not choose. How do you live the fact that you are not being chosen? What do you say to a person was only one of the two candidates? Everybody was celebrating with the one chosen. Well, the unchosen asked, well, what about me? The church is full of Josephs. They're in our families. They love the Lord. But things just have not worked out like they want them to work out. Maybe you are Joseph. You're saying amen right now because you're wondering why other Christians can be less faithful and yet more blessed while you are trying to be more faithful. So my brothers, why not me? Why not me? Have you ever asked that question? Why not me? You're catching it. From every corner, you're tired of living and not being selected. But my brothers and my sisters, and the church, if it's going to be a church cannot just celebrate with Matthias. We also must minister to and embrace Joseph. Joseph meant must feel comfortable that it's all right not to be the one chosen, not to get the job, not to have the doors open, not to make the marriage last, not he making the decisions work. Joseph could have asked, when is it my turn? Like everyone else, I have given my time, talent, and my tenure. I've been focused, I've been faithful, and I've been following. Let me help you here. When is it my time to get something that I want? To have the things flow my way. To make things successful for me. When is it my turn to get a day up front rather than a day from the back? When is it my turn to be selected and considered valuable? We need to minister to Joseph. Because at some point, we all were Josephs. Not picked, Not selected.
Yes, sir.
Not included.
Uh-huh.
Don't you know we got cliques in the church, right? When things are not going our way, what makes this kind of rejection so bad that God did it? The one not chosen must acknowledge the fact that God did not pick me. The lesson is that we must help people understand that being not the one chosen does not mean I'm a failure or a reject. God wants to celebrate me, not my selection, because there are a whole lot of folk selected who are not ready for what they are selected to be. Both men and were presented because they were ready. You got folk in the church claim to be a deacon, but can't even come to Bible study. Can't come to Sunday school. You got people in the choir. Get an attitude because they didn't sing Sunday. Sometimes you don't need to sing. And they think they did the baddest singer in the bunch. Get somewhere and sit down. Joseph would not have been considered had he not been ready to be chosen.
Amen.
He had what it took to do the work among the 12. He was able to handle the job. He could have been good at it. So not being selected does not mean that you're not ready. There are some things that I would not be selected for, but that I am ready for. Why does this happen? Pastor, I'm glad you asked. It happens because some things are affected by human error. When you selected Pastor Johnson, and I'm not saying this, some folk just don't pray. Well, we've been praying to send us a leader, but you know, we look at outer stuff. Oh, he dressed nice. He drive a BMW. He working at Ford. They looking at the material stuff. But God looks at the heart.
Yes, sir.
And some things are affected by unclear and cloudy discernment. Some things God reserved the right to delay you even though you are ready. This is what God wants each of us to develop in our spirit. My not getting something does not mean I was not ready for it. I don't celebrate the rejection, but I celebrate the readiness. I didn't get the job, but I was ready for it. I didn't get the promotion, but I was ready for it. I didn't get selected, but I was ready for it. Don't get drunk on the culture's needs to measure success by selection. Your readiness is a sign that you have navigated your life in a way that would have caused others to give up. And yet, you are still standing.
Yes, sir.
When others are eliminated, you're still holding on. Selection is not always a sign of success, but readiness is.
Yes, sir.
In this Christian life, Frankie Beverly said it best. You're going to have some joy, some pain, like sunshine. Oh, somebody know that song. Providence can never be manipulated by human desire. The providence of God is not subject to our desire and wishes. God is free to choose whom God wants to do God's work. It's a hard fact, the human mind and the spirit to process, because that means God can choose not to choose me.
Uh-huh.
And I must trust God.
Amen.
See, the whole picture, we don't trust God like we ought to.
Uh-huh.
If we trust him, we pay our tithe. Let me help you today. We can get our nails done. We can get us an outfit. Get our hair laid. Go to a worldly concert. Spend $60. But yet we won't give God $10 of tithes. Something wrong with that picture, ain't it? And then we wonder how come our stuff ain't working. It's because we putting God on the back burner. But God ought to be first and foremost in your life. I tell my church, the reason why y'all see me in 3 cars is not because I'm bragging. I'm trying to help you get where you need to be. If you never try to attain what God has for you, you ain't gonna never reach the level that he tried to bring you to, because you still stuck. See, I was once there, stuck on stupid. Y'all been there, you stuck on stupid. But God had to change my thinking. Deacon couldn't change it. The preacher couldn't change it. I had to change.
Yes, sir.
People gathered in Jerusalem, prayed that God would search their hearts. They were looking for the one person to fit the bill. Joseph could find encouragement in that, because after they prayed, the believers were still confused. After they prayed, they were still confused about which of the men should be included and which should not. So this is what they did. They cast lots. They got 2 sticks and inscribed Matthew's name on 1 stick, Joseph's name on the other stick. They placed it in a bag, a garment called a lamp. Then someone shook the garment until one of the sticks fell out. They trusted that God would let only the one of the person chosen name to fall out. So here it is. So when Matthias' name fell out, let me tell you what Joseph did. He didn't complain like some of us. He didn't argue like some of us. He didn't bring no confusion like some of us. Joseph accepted the Lord's will, and he lived on. He understood providence. If there's a hard lesson that the church must teach, you can pray, you can pay tithes, worship God in the spirit and in truth, yet there still will be time when God will choose to do what you don't want God to do. Joseph was already doing what the other disciples were doing. Joseph was with Jesus from the beginning. He had everything necessary to be called an apostle. But he just didn't have the title. I think if I was there counseling him, came into my office and started to complain, I would have listened to him and told him this. Told him how qualified he was. How could they overlook it? Why didn't God think I could do the work? This is what I would have said to him. Joseph, you're right. Yeah, you can do the job. You can do all, you had all the necessary things that the other disciples had. You've been working and witnessing just like the rest of the brothers. You have seen just what they saw. And you know what they know. So I wonder why God would not choose you to be an apostle. Some folk, let me help you today, need to be chosen because they need titles in order to do the work. Let me help you here. Some of y'all fish, don't you? You have fishing license. That don't necessarily mean you know how to fish. Some of y'all, I know a lot of y'all got driving license because you got cars. But that don't necessarily mean you know how to drive. Now, y'all been married a while. Most of y'all. Y'all got married like that. Now, if you ain't treating your spouse the way God wants you to treat them, the marriage like don't mean nothing to you. Listen, you can put bishop in front of my name. You can put doctor, whatever you want to put, pastor. If I ain't living the way God wants me to live, I just got a piece of paper. That's all. But God knew that even if you were not selected to wear the title, you would still do the work. Isn't it true that so many in church need a title to be good Christians? Don't get up thinking that you need to have a title in the church. You don't need to be called no missionary in order to witness and show hospitality to a stranger. You don't need to be a trustee. Clean up God's house. Some of y'all see paper on the floor. Walk right over it. Oh, that's a janitor's job. That's everybody's job. To keep God's house in order. You don't need to be in the choir to sing. Some of y'all can sing better than some of the choir members. To lead a congregational song. You don't need to be a preacher to tell somebody how good God is. You don't even have to be an usher to welcome somebody in the house of God. You know, the ushers is the most important piece when walking in the door. Because, man, if I look at them and they got a scowl on their face, I'm going to walk right back out. So the ushers plays a big part in service. I'm getting ready to leave out of here. You don't have to be in charge to take charge. What you're buying on earth, you're buying in heaven. I don't have to be the one to gain all the glory. I don't have to be the one to tell the story. Not for titles, not for stature. The Bible says, if my people, which I call by my name, shall humble themselves and pray, and turn from their wicked ways. Is there anybody here today that have never been selected for something? Don't give up. Hold on to God's unchanging hand. The wind may blow, the clouds may rise. Hold on to God's unchanging hand. Well, I'm getting ready to go to my seat, but I stopped by here to tell somebody that Jesus loves you. I came to Jesus just as I was. I was weary, wounded, and sad. But I found in him a sweet old resting place. I can't nobody do me like Jesus. I went to my best friend. He wouldn't answer the phone. But I called Jesus one Friday evening. I was about to lose my mind, but I called Jesus. I stepped on one Friday. I was down in my luck, head hung down. But Jesus picked me up one day, turned me around. Is there anybody in here that God have delivered you? Ain't God all right? Do you know he all right? Say yeah, say yeah. I know he's all right. I know the Lord is all right. Woke you up this morning, put food on your table, clothes on your back. He gave you a peace of mind to come in his house this morning. Is there anybody here today feel like giving God a big praise? Praise him every day. Praise him in the morning. Praise him in the evening. Praise him late at night. Ain't God all right? Ain't he all right? Say yeah. Say yeah. 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 I know he's able. I know he's able. Didn't have to wake me this morning, but it did. He looked beyond my faults, saw my needs. Ain't he all right? Ain't the Lord all right? I came, Jesus. Jesus, Mary's baby, born in a stable. Jesus, my will in a meal of a wheel. Jesus, my Jesus, he died. He died. He died. He died. He died. To the moon dripping blood. He died. To the sun blacked out. He died. He wasn't in a coma, but he died. He died. Died for the sins of the world. Tell me he didn't stay dead. Stayed in there all night Friday, all night Saturday. Y'all need to help me early, early Sunday morning. Got up, declared to the world, all power is in my hand. Can't nobody do me like Jesus. Can't nobody pick me up when I'm down. Can't nobody lift me when I'm down. Jesus, 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 the name Jesus cares to the fear of him. Name Jesus, he's time through eternity. The name Jesus, he'll walk with you. He'll talk with you. Yes, he will. Jesus, he's almighty, all powerful, bread in a starving land, bridge over troubled water, baby born in Bethlehem. He's a creator, he's a company keeper, Christ child who was crucified on Calvary. He's a druggist, he's a dietitian, he's a doctor in a sick room. He's everlasting, from everlasting. He's a father, he will give her up grace. Father for the fatherless, he's glory. He's God's gift to man. Yes, he is. He's the host of heaven, higher than the highest. He's in a class all by himself. He's just Jesus. He's Jehovah Jireh. He's justification. Jeremiah's battle axe. He's the King of kings, Lord of lords. Yes, he is. He's the maker of all mankind. He's Macmillan's. He's Noah's rainbow. He's a Nicodemus night school teacher. Yes, he is. Ain't God all right? He's omnipotent. He's omnipresent. He's a preacher. He's a prophet. He's the Prince of Peace. Yes, he is. He's quick to mercy. He's a quiet, a mighty storm. Yes, he is. He's a rock in a weary land. Yes, yes. He's a shelter in a time of storm. He's a tree of life. He's unlimited. He's unsearchable. He's unchanging. If you're weak, worn, and weary, he's a well full of water. Ain't God all right? Ain't he all right? Ain't he all right? Yeah, he's Zacchaeus, then a guest. Yes, he is. He's yearning, yearning for your love. Yeah, yeah, I feel all right now. Yeah, God been good to me. Brought me on down the highway. Keep on blessing me. Ain't God all right? Ain't he all right? Yeah, yeah. Listen, I feel like singing a little bit now. Let me see what I want to sing here. Y'all don't mind, do you? Heartaches, I had my share of heartaches, but I'm still here. Come on, help me, y'all. Trouble, seen my share of trouble, but I'm still here. Bruises, I take my lumps and bruises, but I'm still here. Loneliness, I had my share of loneliness, but I'm still here. Through it all, I made it through another day journey. God kept me here. I made it through another day journey. God kept me here. Listen here. All of what you've been through, listen. Lied on. Many times I've been lied on, but I'm still here. Yes, I am. Burden, had my share of burden, but I'm still here. Dark days, had my share of dark days, but I'm still here. Disappointment, I had my share of disappointment, but I'm still here. Yes, I am. Through it all, I made it through
another day's journey. God bless me. I made it through another day's journey. God kept me. I made it through another day's journey. God kept me.
Stand to your feet.